I'm Griffin from GroupGets, and this is the PureThermal Micro Breakout Board, the newest in the PureThermal lineup. This new module packs the functionality of the original Breakout Board into a footprint not much bigger than the Lepton itself, just 14 by 12.2 millimeters. It can be soldered directly onto a PCB using the castellated edges, or you could use the 10-pin flat flexible cable connector. Perfect for positioning the Lepton module exactly where you need it. I've uploaded a KiCad footprint to make it easy to integrate into your designs. You can download a 3D model and other resources from the GitHub as well. The board is so tiny that the only way to fit a mounting hole was to break it up into four pieces. M2 machine screws can be used at the corners to hold it down. The socket caps need to be 3.8 millimeters or less in diameter. So use low profile socket cap machine screws. Now let's take a look at the pinout diagrams. Only five of these pins are essential: the VIN, ground, chip select, serial clock, and MISO pins are required to get this board running. VIN can be supplied with 3.3 to 5 volts. Hold the chip select pin low. Now to get video over SPI frame data, all you need to do is supply a clock signal. The maximum is 20 megahertz, but 18 megahertz is good enough. The Lepton also has a command control interface, or CCI, which uses an I2C bus for writing and reading from the Lepton's 16-bit registers. The CCI does a lot. Check out section 4 of the Lepton's engineering datasheet to learn more about what the CCI can do. But you don't need to worry too much about that, because we have example code. I'm going to show you how to get the MicroBob up and running on a Raspberry Pi. First, get your hardware set up. The easiest way to do that is to use an FFC breakout board. Connect the micro module to these pins on the Raspberry Pi GPIO header. The FFC connector is double-sided, so pay attention to the orientation of the cable to be sure one end isn't reversed. I made this simple adapter board, but I also could have just used some jumpers. I'm also powering the Raspberry Pi from a bench power supply. I first tried powering the Raspberry Pi over USB, but it was giving me low voltage warnings and the video was lagging. Now let's get started with the software. First, we'll clone the Lepton module repository. Make sure the SPI and I2C interfaces are enabled. You'll need qmake to compile the code. First, I tried installing Qt4 DevTools, but that doesn't work on the newer versions of the Raspbian operating system. If you also get this error, update apt and try installing Qt5 Dev instead. Now navigate to the Raspberry Pi video folder. From here, you can compile the code. This might take a while. Once that's done, it's pretty much ready to run. Just a few things first. If you're using a Raspberry Pi 4, there is one more thing you need to do before you can run the program. Just enter this line in the terminal. Now, if you're using a Lepton 3, 3.5, or FS, use this to run the program. You should see a little window pop up with the thermal video. Congratulations, it's up and running. You can use this same procedure for the original PureThermal breakout board. The Lepton module repository has a lot more code that I didn't mention. Just have a look. We may have exactly what you need for you to get started with your project. You can buy the PureThermal Micro Breakout Board on store.groupgets.com. For high volume orders, send an email to sales@groupgets.com. If you run into trouble developing custom software or firmware, check out the FLIR Lepton Google group. For all other inquiries, you can reach us at help@groupgets.com. In the next video, we'll do some power measurements and test the limits of this board. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss it.